So let's take a look at getting indexes and using them in a way that's meaningful. So let's say I've got this list and I just want to print things out. So print each, and you'll see that obviously we just get them all in one string. Print my list. And we get them all in one kind of list there. Maybe I want to work at these a little bit differently. Maybe I want to put them in a different order. Maybe I want Alice to come first, and then Bob, and then Mr. B. So now that we know that we have indexes, it's easy enough to print these by index. So take a look at this. I'm just going to take my list and then use my square bracket to say I want index number 2, and then I want index number 4, my list, index 4, and then I'm going to get index 0, index my list, index 0, and we can see that that will let us put these things in different orders. Now I've got Alice, Mr. B, and Bob. So you can see how you can pull things in and out of lists. I'm going to show you how to put stuff in there in just a minute. But you can see how you can pull stuff out of a list in any order you want it. So if I just wanted to work with, say, this third item in the list, index 0.2, I could just loop through it and just pull out index 2 over and over again. In fact, let's take a look at that. If I were to just do the same thing and say, for each in range 10, and I could print, yeah, I need an in there, don't I? Print, but let's finish that, my list, index 2. So I just want to each in, I just want to say I want Alice, but I want to see Alice 10 times, you know. So I can, as you can see, by using fours, we can actually loop through things. Obviously, this is more useful if you're working with big lists of information, but that's kind of how it works.